Good evening, print friends, and welcome back from the future. It's now the present day, so what happens next technically happens before what happened in episode 1. Try to keep up. It's like Lost Series 5, but without the fat one. And this is Printfriends Publishing. Inside these painstakingly handcrafted cardboard walls, the CEO, Molkozoy, is in a meeting with a certain tea-loving nitwit who may just change his life forever.
So you want me to tell you the story of my life? Well, I'll tell you. I'll tell you all of it.
Well, yes. That is usually what happens in an autobiography.
So, you're definitely interested in publishing it?
Oh, absolutely. Let me tell you, this book is going to be huge.
How huge?
Well, we've put together a mock-up.
Wow, that is huge.
Yeah, and that's only based on Chapter 1, which was amazing, by the way. Who'd have thought that Richard Nixon was actually a mutated computer virus? So, when do you think you'll be able to get the rest of it to us?
Well, I'm afraid I need to do a little more traveling first.
But you've traveled all through time and cyberspace. I mean, surely that's enough material.
Unfortunately, my horse Cloppins did a paper mache on my computer and I lost most of my photographs, so I need to go and take some more. Such a pity. I had a hilarious one of King Tutankhamun the night he got off his face on Sphinx milk and ended up climbing a pyramid with a road cone on his head. Funny guy. Terrible teeth. But several years ago, I lost someone very dear to me. I couldn't bear the pain of her loss. I longed to be released from it.
So, you became a vampire?
No, I just took some antidepressants.
Oh, well, this is all fascinating. I must tell you, I haven't been this excited since I found out my ex-wife had been decapitated in a horrific skiing accident. This is going to be amazing.
Well, yes, but you know, it's not all debauched medieval banquets and sexual encounters with paperclips. With great power comes great responsibility.
What do you mean?
Well, I mean that when you have great power, it often comes with great responsibility.
Yeah. I got that. But in what way?
Oh! Well, as a result of my time traveling, I have an intricate binary equation lodged in my brain which could potentially be used to turn all of existence into virtual reality.
Great laser print! And are you gonna put this in the book?
No, probably not. Knowing my luck, it'd be stolen by a crazed megalomaniac bent on ruling the universe. Or Stephen Hawking. I figure I should just leave the equation inside my brain. It's safer there.
Fascinating. So listen, I'll get my people to draw up a contract and let's talk as soon as you get back with your photographs. Deal?
Ding-a-dee-dong.
What?
Yes.
Follow Fistigan's unfolding adventures at youtube.com/printfriends.
This is gonna make me a billionaire. It's a license to print money. Wingleby, get your feathery ass in here.